we're going to start with a nice easy warm-up. This is going to be a slow moving class today. And we're going to keep an eye on those basic movement patterns on our breathing. So first, just find your feet, rocking back and forth between the balls of the feet and the heels. Reach up, breathe in. And pull forward. Good. Now bend the knees, roll up. Shoulders down. Reach up, breathe in. And pull forward. Bend the knees, roll up. Shoulders down. Reach up. And pull forward. One more time, bend the knees, roll up. Reach up. And pull forward. Good. And we're going to roll up. Shoulders down, come to the center, and widen up the feet. Hands to the hips, bend the right knee. And straighten up. Other side. Make sure your toes are pointed forward in the direction you're facing. They never move. Yeah. Stabilize them right there. And I want you to check too that your knee is always over the ankle or inside. Never, never let the knee go outside the ankle. We want to keep that foot nice and solid on all four corners of the feet. Take a look at the mirror. Make sure your knee never goes outside the ankle. Tuck it in. Tuck it in. Lift up. Good. Yes. And other side. And lift. So standing tall in the middle. We always finish the movement before we start the next one. So lifting up high in the middle and bending that knee. One more time. So this is our dynamic stretch to open up the hips. Good. Hold here in the center. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Bend the knees, roll up. Shoulders down. Reach up. And fold forward. So adopting this wide-legged stretch. Bend the knees, roll up. Shoulders down. Reach up. Two more just like that. Fold forward. Bend the knees, roll up. Shoulders down. Reach up. Last one here. Fold forward. Now walk out into downward dog, and we're just going to tap one toe. Place the hand, tap the other toe, place the hand. Holding in downward dog, nothing moves but your shoulder. Good. Shoulders down away from the ears, keep your belly button sucked in toward the spine. Give me four more, two on each side. Three, two, and one. Okay, let's walk back. Then the knees roll up, shoulders down, and reach up. So we're going to do a little bit of balance and standing glute and core engagement in our warm-up today too. So standing nice and tall, let's shift to our left foot. We're going to tip from the hip and extend the right leg straight back behind us. Hands to hips or behind the back. Now lift that heel up if you can and pulse. One, two, three, four. Don't let your body move at all. Focus your gaze on anything that's not moving. Good. Yeah. Four more for 16. Three, two, one, and bring that foot down. Stand tall, or you can fold forward if you need to. Other side, shifting. Extend that leg back. Hold first. Suck your belly button toward the spine. Now pulse. One, two, going for 16. Four, keep the shoulders down and back. Relax the neck. Good, yeah. That's 12, 13. Good, yeah. Last one, and bring back. Now inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward, and we're going to walk out into plank or downward dog. If you're in plank, you can be down on the knees, no problem. I just want you to hold here for a moment and check your form. In plank, we never let the hips drop or the head drop. Suck your belly button in. Make sure your hips do not come down toward the floor. Just breathe here for a moment. And we're going to walk it back into forward fold. Bend the knees, reach up. Good. And again, fold forward, walk out into downward dog for less, plank into more. Good, yeah? And lift the hips, take it back. And reach up. Breathe in deep. Exhale, fold forward. Walk it out, shoulders stay down. Lift the hips, walk it back. Reach up, breathe in. And fold forward. Good, and walk it out. Four strong. Lift the hips. Walk it back. And the knees roll up, reach up, inhale, and fold forward. Good, walk it out. Last one right here. Walk it back to forward fold. Good, reach up, breathe in, and release the arms. Excellent. Okay, so now another balancing option for the lower body. Shifting to the right side, hands to the hips or behind the back. And now we're going to extend that other leg out to the side. Now once it's there, I can flex the foot back toward you, and then push that leg back past the midline of the body, keeping it straight. We don't bend the knee to get there. Now pulse. One, two. We want to feel it here. Don't touch. relax down. Yeah, hands can be anywhere that's comfortable for you. Suck your belly button toward the spine. 6, 5, 4. Good, yeah. Last one, and release, shake it off. Other side, shifting, lifting that leg out to the side, toes flex back toward you, and I want you to push that heel back. Make sure the toes are pointed forward, and we're pulsing through the ankle and the knee. 3, good. 4, push the leg back, past the midline of the body. Good. If the leg is in front of the midline of the body, we target our hip flexors. We don't want that, we want the glute knee. So that's why we push it back like that. Last one, and release. Excellent. Okay, let's make our way down to the floor now for some mat work. So if you have a mat, I want you to roll it out. You're going to come to the back of your mat. You're going to stand tall to start. Breathe in, reach up. And fold forward. Walk out into downward dog. And we're going to come into a little bear crawl progression. So hips are lifted in downward dog. We're going to take a deep breath here. And then bend the knees. Bring them down to the hips. Just hold here. And lift up toward the sky. So when we come into bear crawl, the hands are under the shoulders, knees are directly under the hips. Lift the hips toward the sky. We're moving super slow. Bring them down. 3, 2, 1, and up. 3, 2. So when you come down, you're bending your knees underneath the hips. Yes. 1, and up. 3, 2, 1, and down. 3, 2, 1, and up. 3, 2, 1. So this is a reminder that this class is all about precision. It's not about how fast we can move. It's about how well we can move. Last one. 3, 2, 1, and up. 3, 2, 1. Now knees to floor. Sit back. Quick stretch. Let's come onto our back on the mat. And down onto the floor. And we're going to come into a glute bridge. So your gaze is toward the sky. Do not turn your head when there's pressure on the neck, such as when we're up in our bridge pose. Check your knees are pointing toward the sky and there's perfect alignment. Knees, hips, and ankles, arms relaxed to the sides. Take a deep breath in. Exhale slowly. Peel the back up off the floor and we're going to hold on top. Now single breath, slow down. 3, 2, 1, and up. 3, 2, moving super slow down. 3, 2, 1, and up. 3, 2, 1, and down. 3, 2, 1, and up. 3, 2. Now we're going to do 2 more just like that. Keep it slow, and I want you to focus. Lift your toes up off the floor so you can make sure you're pushing into the heels. Make sure your heels are hip width apart. The ankles never come together. Now we're going to double time if you're ready. Down and up. Down and up. Good. Yeah, that's 3 of 16. Mm-hmm. And 5. Really good. 6. Looks great, guys. Nice form. There's 7 and 8. Halfway there. 9. We should be waking up those glutes now. They're going to help us for the rest of our workout. Good. 12. 13. Keep that belly button sucked in toward the spine. 2 more just like that. Last one, and you can roll down, bring the knees into the chest. You can come back to any of those movements that we've done already anytime. And we're going to come back to our glute bridge for a single leg option. So I'd like you to center the left foot between the hips. Right knee comes to the chest, and we extend that leg up toward the sky. And now we're going to pulse. 1, 2, 3. Push into your supporting heel. Breathe. Nice. 9, 10 of 16. Try and touch your toe to the ceiling. Good, yeah. 2 more just like that. Hold it. Spread your arms wide. Press them into the floor. We're going to keep that leg perfectly straight and lower it out to the side. And then back up. 6 reps. Ready? Down. And up. And down. And up. Keep it nice and slow and down. Really good job. Yeah, and up. So remember, we don't turn that head. We keep the gaze toward the ceiling. You have 2 more. Push into your supporting heel. Lift the hips a little higher if you can. Last one, and up. Foot comes to the floor. And we're going to hold it. Shoulders down, neck is long, and the other knee comes to the chest, and we extend that leg up toward the sky. Let's pulse. 1, 2, 3. Push into your heel. 5, suck the belly button in. And breathe. Uh-huh. That's 11, 12, them down and back. Two more just like that. Five. And last one right here. And six. Awesome. Feet to the floor. Roll the back down for a great time. Knees come into the chest. And we give that lower body a little bit of a rest. And now we come into abdominal muscles. Shins up parallel with the floor. Relax the arms to the sides. First thing I'm going to do is suck your belly button toward the spine and press your lower back down to the floor. Then we're going to tap the heel on one side, bring it back. Other side, bring it back. And tap and bring it back. Tap and bring it back. Good, yes. Excellent, you got it. So I want you to make sure that in this movement, we're rotating from the hip, not dropping the heel down toward the thigh. You guys look great, you're doing an awesome job. And if you want more, you can straighten the leg out and almost tap that heel to the floor. Again, we're sucking the belly button toward the spine and pressing the lower back down to the floor. Breathe, relax your neck and shoulders. We're gonna do four more. Four, three, two, and one, and release. Quick stretch. Excellent. Okay, windshield wipers to finish off the lower ab set. Shins up once again, parallel with the floor, arms are wide. We're just gonna tip to one side, 45 degrees, then back to center. Other side, 45, and back to center, and tip, and center. And I want you to move super slow, so you can really target those muscles, especially in the side body, and the muscles that come from the one hip bone to the opposite rib cage. Across the front of the abs. Down and center. If you want more, straighten out the legs to 45 degrees. Good. Yeah. And tip. And center. Two more just like that. Just one on each side. Excellent. And the last one. Feet to floor. Great job. So that was from the belly button down. Now we're going to come into that band across the belly button and up higher. So we're going to come into our standard crunch. Fingertips to temple or behind the head, and I'd like you to lift your heels for just a little bit more. Take a deep breath, exhale, lift up, just barely lift your shoulder blades up off the floor, and hold here, because we're gonna check our form first. Your chin never comes to the chest. Gaze is towards the sky, and there's always at least a fist distance between chin and chest. Okay, single reps, down and up, and down and up. When you lift, I want you to think about lifting your nose up toward the ceiling. Good, down and up. Down and up. Inhale down, exhale up. Keep your elbows nice and wide, and you should feel that space above the belly button where your ribs come together in front. That's what we're targeting there. Good. Four more. Three, keep the elbows nice and wide. Last two, last one. Excellent. And release. Okay, now higher up into the upper abdominals, I'm going to show you our starter move. We're going to reach toward the sky with those arms and then reach them above the body, just barely touching the thumbs to the floor. And at the same time, I want you to suck your belly button toward the spine and push the lower back into the floor. You should feel this up here through the ribcage. Now we're going to reach for the sky and do a T-heel crunch. Inhale down, press the thumbs, hold, squeeze the shoulder blades down, reach for the sky, tiny crunch, hold on top, and then come down, reach the thumbs toward the floor, hold, shoulders down. And reach for the sky, tiny crunch, hold on top. And come on down, reach the arms above. Hold here, shoulders squeeze down. One more time, reach for the sky, tiny crunch, hold on top. And then come on down, arms up above, and squeeze, shoulders down. Great job. Okay, you can stick with that move, or come with me for our little Pilates crunch. A little bit more intense, same target area, right up here, push down on top. So come with me, sit up. And we're going to set up nice and tall, shoulders are down, back, away from the ears. Your option is to grasp behind the thighs, or you can come with me and reach the arms up to the line of the ears. Key point is that we must have a straight spine, and I want you to tip back. So we have an angle on the body, we are not sitting perfectly upright unless we must. So we're leaning back to target those abdominal muscles. Now I want you to think about holding an orange right here. Take a deep breath in, exhale, and crush the orange right there. And lift up, inhale, exhale, crush. And lift. So when we crush, we are not squeezing the shoulders in. It's all right here. Exhale, crush. And lift. So arm positioning is all up to you. It's whatever is comfortable. And what we want to really focus on is that shoulders are down and back throughout the movement. And we're feeling it here in that band. Good, yeah? And lift. One more time, exhale, squeeze, and lift. Right on, and release. So movements like that are designed to target very specific muscle groups that we want to use for specific purposes and also make stronger so our whole body works better. Grab a drink of water, and we'll come into a little bear crawl series. So now let's come down to hands under shoulders, knees under hips, in a table position. You can stay in a table position, or you can come with me for a bear crawl, which means we're curling the toes under. Shoulders are down and back, whatever position you're in. Elbows are on a slight bend, because we want to feel like we're about to do a push-up here. That's the kind of strength we have. And we're going to inhale, and then exhale, just barely lift the knees up off the floor. So we came here in our warm-up, and now we're going to pulse in that spot, just 2 to 3 inches. Nice, nice, good job. Suck your belly button toward the spine. Keep the shoulders down away from the ears. Nice. 4, 5, 6, 2 more, just like that. Last one, knees down, sit back into child's pose. Great, now you can stay here as long as you like, or come with me, we're going to shift forward. Bear crawl, good. And then shift back into child's pose. Toes can curl under, just sit back in the heels. Then forward into bear crawl, back into child's pose. Forward into bear crawl or table, back into child's pose. Now, if you're ready for more, when you come into bear crawl, lift the knees up, just that inch off the floor. Sit back, child's pose. You can keep the knees lifted in child's pose as well. Shoulders stay down away from the ears, and we're sucking the belly button toward the spine. 4 more. Really nice. Yeah, good job. And 3. And back. And last 2. And back. Last 1 here. And back. Great. Knees down. Quick stretch. Great. Back to our bear crawl position. So remember that your knees can stay on the floor. You can come with me, curl the toes under. Lift the knees just an inch up off the floor. And then from here, we're going to do some taps. So just lift one heel and the other. It's a little march. And I want you to really focus and notice that your knees are not moving at all. Knees stay underneath the hips. And we're just lifting one heel and then the other. Just a little tap. Squeeze it up toward the bum. Good. Yes, yes. Good. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Knees down. Quick stretch. Nice job. All right, now let's come into a plank pose, knees or toes. It's all up to you. So the next move we're gonna do is a little hand release. So, hand release and upward face. Check your hands under your shoulders. I want your knees or your feet wide. We're gonna keep the arms straight and just lift one arm up and back down. Lift and lower. Nice, yeah. So you'll notice whatever position you're in, your core has to work, and you really have to drive down through that shoulder to make this happen. Breathe. 4 more. 3, 2, and 1. You can take a break, or you can hold in plank. We're going to come to our next move, plank bird dog, or table bird dog. Reaching out opposite arm to leg, reach, and bring it back down. Other side. Reach, and bring it down. Nice, yes. And reach, so remember, your knees can be on the floor if that's what's more comfortable for you. It's all yours. We're just working on core stability and balance. So if we feel like we're being too challenged here, we always want to take it down a notch. We're going to build that strength in perfect form first. Breathe. Awesome. One more on each side. Nice and slow, last one here. Hands down, knees down, quick stretch. Excellent job. Okay, let's come on up through our forward fold to standing. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. Stand up, reach up. And release. Excellent. Okay, we're going to come into a standard squat and then a little pendulum lunge. So I want you to start by stomping your feet to the floor. We are off the mat now. Hands wherever is comfortable for you. And we're just going to squat down. And up. So when we squat, I want you to make sure that your knees, hips, and ankles are all lined up on a straight plane, and the weight is always in the heels. You can test that by lifting your toes just a little bit, especially at the bottommost point in your movement, yeah? And we want to be pushing into the outside of the feet. Suck the belly button toward the spine. Let's finish with pulses at the bottom. Hold on the bottom, and pulse. 1, 2, 3, 16. Bend the back knee forward underneath the hip as low as you can. Back heel is up off the floor because we're pushing that back knee forward. Tailbone is tucked. Just hold at your bottommost point. It might be all the way down. Push on the hip, let the body drop straight down. Front knee is over your ankle. And we're pushing back up through that heel. Let's speed it up. Step in, back, lunge, and up. In, back, lunge, and up. So I want you to, especially if these movements are new to you, really notice the parts of the movement. It's not just one slow movement, it's several. Back, down, and up, and in, exactly. So we want to be precise with each fraction of this movement. Good, look for that alignment. Excellent. One more time on each side. Last one here. And down, and up, nice. So you can come back there anytime you have your squatting time, or you can pendulum lunge with me. We're going to start with just a little test. First, we balance on one foot. All right, step the other leg back, lunge, down. Now we're going to come up and tap in or lift, and then bring that foot forward. Keep point, land soft, like your knee is a spring. Knee is always over the ankle or behind. You feel a little bit glute. We just woke up. Good, yes. Now push into your front heel and lift or tap. Bring it back and sink. Good, yes. Faster, lift and sink, and lift and sink. When you lift up, I want you to push into your supporting leg. Nice, and tap. Beautiful, and lift and tap. Breathe deep and lift and tap. Really nice, really nice. One more time, forward and back. Lift and tap. Last one here. Lift and tap. And really shake it off. Great job. Yes. So now we're going to move on to the other side. Standing tall, shifting to that left leg. Finding our balance first. And that right leg's going to come back. Doesn't matter what side you're on, really. And we're going to sit down. And lift up. Land soft on the front heel. Good. Yes. Really good. Yeah. And back. And lift. So that knee is a spring. We just want to land so there's no impact. Exactly. You got it. And back. And suck the belly button in, find that focus, forward, and lift. Two more just like that, back, and lift, beautiful, and forward, and lift. Ooh, keep breathing, last one here, forward and back. And stand tall, beautiful, yeah? And release, shake it off, great job, guys. Okay, so some combo moves now. Grab a drink of water anytime you need one. We're coming to the back of our mat once again, so if you've got one, you can roll it out. Good, and we'll start by taking a deep breath in. For a walk out, fold forward, walk it out into downward dog, and we're again going to come into bear crawl and downward dog. And bear crawl and downward dog. Bear crawl and downward dog. One more time, and then we're going to introduce our bear squat like we did before. We're going to bear crawl, sit back into the heels, bear crawl, and downward dog. Let's do it again. Bear crawl, knees under hips, sit back, child's pose. Bear crawl, knees under hips, and lift up, down dog. So again, bear crawl, knees under hips, sit back, child's pose. Bear crawl, knees under hips, lift up, downward dog. Really nice, yeah. Down, knees under hips, and shift back, child's pose. Knees under hips, now we're going to complicate things if you'd like. Now, bear crawl, raise one arm. Sit back. Good. And forward, hand down, downward dog. Listen on the other side. Knees down, bear crawl, raise the other arm. Squat back. Forward, hand down, downward dog. Let's do it again. Knees under hips, raise one arm, sit back. Shift forward, hand down, downward dog. Other side, you do not have to raise that arm if it's not comfortable for you. And forward, down dog. Now we're going to release the knees to the floor. Take a little break. Nice. Rugby squat now. Single arm bear squat with one arm to the side. Curl the toes under. Lift the knees up off the floor or don't. It's all up to you. We're going to reach one arm to the side. Sit back and center your hand down. Other side. Out. Shift. Center and down. Out. Shift. Center and down. Knees can be down on the floor. All yours. We're just looking for precision of movement and perfect alignment. Good, yeah. Keep those shoulders way down, away from the ears. One more time on each side. Reach, shift, center, and down. and then some side plank stuff before I pull down. So extending one leg straight back. We're going to arc and tap outside the opposite foot, then arc and tap in line with the hip. Good. Lift and tap. Lift and tap. So as you complete this movement, I want you to think about pushing into your elbows, pushing into your supporting knee, checking that your shoulders are down away from the ears, and the neck is long and control. Good, you got it. Breathe one more time just like that in both directions. Then we're going to hold that leg up high, flex the foot back toward the body, and pulse it. Think of lifting through the knee rather than through the heel. Don't bend the knee, keep it straight. Suck the belly button toward the spine. You have four more. Four, three, two, and one. Knees down. Sit back. Other side. Elbows under shoulders. Straighten out that other leg. Lift and tap. Lift and tap. So I want you to notice all of the exercises that we're doing are full body exercises. Even though we have a target area, all of our muscles are working. So check it with your core, check it with your arms and your supporting leg, check your neck is relaxed. Make sure your knee stays straight. Don't bend the knee, you're also targeting hamstrings more than glutes. So focus, focus, suck the belly button toward the spine. Two more just like that. Last one here, up and tap. Now we'll hold that leg up and pulse. One, two, three. Keep that belly button tight. This should be getting hard. Push into your supporting heel. Seven, six, five, four. Great job. Last one. Knees down. And stretch. Excellent. Okay. Now we're going to come down onto the floor. I was going to start with obliques, but let's actually start with that side plank. So the side plank is going to, it's going to wake up our obliques, and those are the muscles on the side of the body. So I want you to come here with me on the bottom elbow. Your bottom shoulder is down away from the ear, and the elbow is directly under the shoulder. We're going to lift the hips up off the floor. Your knee can be down. And I want you to first think about flattening your body up against an imaginary wall. So push your bottom knee back so that when you look down, you cannot see it, or you can barely see it. So it should be pushed right back. Good, perfect. Now we're going to pulse those hips, and if you want more, you can straighten the legs and stack the feet or row them up. Keep the neck long, don't look towards your toes, look straight ahead. Good, yeah, perfect. I want you to feel those tiny little muscles. Two more, last one. Good. Now that bottom knee is going to come down. We're going to take a deep breath in and reach the top arm up alongside the ear, then exhale and pull the top knee and elbow together. Inhale and reach out. Exhale, pull it in. Try and point both the knee and the elbow toward the sky. Exhale, pull it in. Nice, yeah. Inhale, reach. And exhale, pull it in. If this becomes too challenging, especially if there's tension or pain in your neck and shoulders, you can lay all the way down on the floor to complete the movement. Two more just like that. And pull it in. And last one. And pull it in. Now let's come to plank. Or you can rest right away if you need to. Just plank on the elbows or take a break. Knees or toes. Push your shoulders down. Good. Now sit back, child's pose. Quick break. Well done. Let's come along to the other side. So elbow under shoulder. And your bottom knee can be down. Or you can stack the feet or row the feet. And we're looking for that pulse to start. Good, yes, really good. Yeah, looking awesome, guys. We're almost there, too. We're almost to our stretch. Breathe deep. Press that bottom shoulder down. Nice. Six, five, four. Right on. Now bottom knee comes down. We'll reach that top arm up alongside the ears. We inhale. Exhale, pull. Knee toward the elbow. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Inhale, reach. Give me three more just like that. Drive that bottom elbow down. Don't let the shoulder hike up. Last one. Now into plank. Knees or toes, or take a break if you need one. Suck the belly button toward the spine. And then if you want a little more, come with me in body style. We're going to shift the body forward and then back. Keep those shoulders way down, away from the ears. Whew. Breathe. stretch those arms out in front or back by your sides. Okay, let's do a little bit more posterior chain, so muscles in the back of our body. Before we finish up here, so a little crab walk position. I'd like you to just sit on the floor, the soles of your feet on the floor, knees and ankles lined up, and the hands are going to come behind you. If this is not comfortable for your shoulders at any point, you can always lay right down on the floor. And I just want you to lift the hips just a little bit. Good. Now opposite hands and leg lifts, and then put it back down. Good. Yes. Opposite arms and leg, and put it back down. Balancing poses like this are great because we don't have our fall, but what I want you to make sure of is that your shoulders stay down away from the ears, and the elbows remain in a slight bend, so that we're protecting our joints and training in proper movement patterns. Hips can be on the floor for this movement. Yeah? You're still going to be working your abs. Yes. Excellent. Yeah? Keep those shoulders going down. Now, if you want more, tap the toe or tap the knee. Yeah? Excellent. Right on it. So check in with your body. Shoulders are down and back away from the ears, no matter what position we're in. And if you want more, you can always speed it up. If you want less, you can always slow it down. Just remember, it's your class. Good. Three more. Two more. Last one. Excellent. So you can release. Relax down. Relax the arms. Now for our next movement, you have two options. You can be up here with me with the hips lifted, or you can lay all the way down on the floor. We're going to be doing some heel taps. So here, do not come in between and sit on the floor, else you will end up with neck tension. So I recommend laying down if you're not able to sustain this lifted position. Knees are up toward the sky, no matter what position you're in, and we're just going to tap one heel and the other. Just little taps out and in. And if your hips are lifted, you can come into more of a tabletop position. You can also lay down on the floor and come into a bridge pose to tap your heels. Mm-hmm. Good, yeah? Now we're going to turn this into four steps. Ready? Let's go. Four, three, two, one, back, three, two, one. Four, three, two, one, back, three, two, one. If your hips are lifted, shoulders are wide. Don't let them crowd the ears. Neck is long. That one more time. Out, three, two, one, in, three, two, one, hips down. Straighten up the legs, and we'll relax down. So, anterior delts are a little muscle group that almost never gets used, really. So we want to make sure that we're strengthening those tiny muscles too. We're just about to come into our stretch. Is there anything you guys feel like you missed? I feel like we could do a little bit of abductor, or adductor rather. So a little hand thigh. Let's lay down. We haven't done this move in a little while, so we're going to come right down on the floor. It's our chance to lay down. I'm going to straighten out the bottom leg, and I want you to make a straight line, like you're flattening your body up against an imaginary wall, pointing your bottom toe. Your top leg is going to come in front for balance. The toes just come to the floor, and then once we're there, this top hand can come in front. Don't let your body come forward, and we're going to lift that bottom leg. Now, once you're here, I want you to just hold. And make sure you have enough padding on the bottom side that you're going to be comfortable here. And we're going to pulse the leg. One, two, three, four. Relax your neck and shoulders. Good. Eight, we're doing 16. Suck your belly button in. Three more. Two. Now circles. One, two, three, four. Think of moving through the hip. Freeze your knee and ankle. Right on. Six more, five, four, don't tense up. Last two, last one, and release. Great job, all over. So again, flattening our body up against that imaginary wall, fingertip right down to your toe on the bottom leg, and we're gonna bring that top leg in front, lift the bottom leg, and pulse. One, two, three, four, good. Suck your belly button toward the spine. Breathe deep. On. Only four more of those. Three, two, now circles. One, two, three. Think of moving from that hip. Relax your shoulders. Relax the jaw. Halfway there. Eight, seven, six, five. Right on. Last one. And release. Excellent. Okay, come on up. We're going to start with a wide legged stretch. So just sitting up nice and tall, wide legged staff. Fingertips come to the floor in front of us. And we're just going to tip forward. And relax down with the legs. We're not trying to get super deep into the stretch, we're just trying to feel the stretch, the insides of the thighs that we just worked so hard. And we're breathing deeply into those muscles, relaxing as we exhale. Exhale. And now when you're ready, you can come with me and walk the hands over toward the right leg. And then we're just going to relax down over that leg. Make sure the knees stay nice and straight. And we're feeling that stretch in the left lower side body. If you'd like more, crawl those left fingertips toward the instep of the right foot. Breathe. Great. And walk it back in and over toward the other side. And just relax down over that leg, pinching up. Widen back as you inhale. Relax wherever you can as you exhale. Good. And we'll bring it back to center and lock it up. Right foot comes to the inside of the left calf or thigh for half step. Shoulders square toward the extended leg, as close as you can get. You breathe in deep. And fold forward as we exhale. Right fingertips can crawl forward toward the instep of the left foot if you'd like. And we're feeling that stretch down the right lower side body. Good. Lock the hands back up. Hands come behind you. I'm going to switch sides. Sitting up tall, squaring the shoulders toward the extended leg. Take a deep breath in. And we'll tip from the hip. Good. Relax the arms. Relax the neck. Nice deep breathing. And we'll walk it back up. Hand comes to the other knee. And we'll reach out, full side bend. Good. Same thing on the other side. Suck your belly button through the spine. So opposite hand to the bent knee. Opposite hand to the bent knee. Yep. Opposite hand. Yep. So your right hand to the left knee. Yep, exactly. And reach up and feel the rib cage open. Makes a difference, eh? Good. Yeah, good. And then we'll come on up. Hands behind us. I'm going to switch sides. The exact same thing on the other side. So again, opposite hand to that bent knee. Reach across, yep. Exactly, yep. And reach up. Perfect, you got it, yes. And then we bend. And we keep our belly button sucked in toward the spine to protect the lower back while we bend. And then we'll come on up, release the hands behind us. And we'll extend both legs, one more full step, relax right down. Great, press up, roll over, hands on your shoulders, and we'll lift the hips up toward the sky. Gently pressing those heels toward the floor and breathing deeply. Great, let's walk the hands back toward the feet, forward fold. And then bend the knees, roll up, shoulders down, reach up. Release down through prayer. Awesome, okay, so now coming into a little warrior series. I just want you to step one leg straight back. Tuck the tailbone, and we're going to feel that stretch begin in that right hip flexor. So the front to the back hip. Good. Gently press your back heel toward the floor. Make sure your toes are pointed forward. And when you're ready, you can reach up with your arm on the back leg side or with both arms and then sink a little deeper. Good. Gently press into that back heel. One more deep breath in. And we're going to exhale, bring the back knee down to the floor and the hands to the inside of the front foot. Good. Yes. Excellent. If this is not comfortable, or elbow can come to the front thigh anytime that our back knee is right down on the floor or as close as we can comfortably get it. Good. And now we're going to place our hand on the front knee and look out toward the sky, allowing our shoulders to follow. If you want a deeper stretch here, lift your back knee up off the floor and then reach up toward the sky with the top arm or wrap around behind the body. Breathe in the stretch wherever you're feeling it today. Relax wherever you're able. Great, and now we'll reach up toward the sky, hands down to either side of the front foot, step forward into forward fold. Other side, step your other leg back, arms come out to the sides and overhead for warrior one. We're going to use the front knee for leverage, or bring the hands to the hips or behind the back anytime. Check your back foot is pointed forward, and we're gently pressing back heel toward the floor. Tailbone is tucked, you lace up the core, and feel that stretch. Good, sink a little deeper into your ankle, push down to the front heel. Breathing deeply always. Excellent. One more deep breath in. Exhale, hands down to the inside of the front foot. Back knee comes down to the floor. You can shift that back knee back further or the front foot forward more if you'd like. And our hand on the front knee side, we'll come to that knee, shoulders down, inhale and extend the spine first, and then we exhale and look up for the sky. When you feel ready, you can lift the back knee up off the floor, you can reach for the sky with that top arm, you can wrap it around behind the body if you'd like, shoulders are wide, good, sink a little deeper if you can. And breathe. Good job. Now let's reach up for the sky, hands to either side of the front foot, and we'll step into forward fold. Now let's bend the knees, roll up one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders down and back, reach up, breathe in. Then we'll release down. We have just enough time for our figure four and our T-band stretch. So standing nice and tall, shifting the weight from the left leg, bend the left knee. Right shin comes across the front, and draw that leg in place and sit right down. Good, you can press that knee down if you like. Arch the lower back if you want more, and if you're feeling well balanced and ambitious, you can reach toward the floor, fingertips can come down, good. Breathe, relax the arms, relax the neck. And let's come on up and see if you can find your balance while you release that top leg and swing it around behind. Good, nice job, yeah, standing tall, suck the belly button toward the spine, hand on the front leg side comes to the hip, arm on the back leg side reaches up, we squeeze the core, and then we bend. Opening up the rib cage. Your left hand can stay on the hip for spinal support, or you can reach across the front of the body to deepen the stretch. Breathe, expand the ribs. Relax wherever you're able. Really good. Check that bottom shoulders, relax down away from the ear. And then we'll inhale, come on up. Tip forward from the hip, hands come to the front, bend the knee. Lift your tailbone toward the sky, and you can relax down toward the floor if you'd like to come a little deeper into the stretch. Good. Now hands to the front, bend the knee. We'll step out to hip width, roll up, shoulders down, reach up. And release down through prayer, release the arms. Great, coming along to the other side, shifting to the right leg now, bend the right knee, left shin comes into position. You can draw it into that spot if you'd like, and we're sitting right down, arching the lower back up toward the sky, and that left thigh is stretching out, the left hip is stretching out. Hands again come into prayer, or you can reach to the floor and sit forward, or you can hang on to that leg if you need to. Relax the shoulders, relax the jaw. And now let's come on up. Find your balance if you're able. Release that left leg, bring it behind, stand tall. Hand on the front leg side comes to the hip. Arm on the back leg side reached up. Suck the belly button toward the spine. And gently bend. You can reach that arm across the front of the body if you like. Good. Breathe. Open up that rib cage. Excellent. Now inhale and come up. Exhale, tip from the hip, hands come to the front, bend the knee. Lift your tailbone up toward the sky. And you can relax a little deeper into that stretch if you like. Good. Breathing deeply. Good. Now hands to the front, bend the knee. Step out to hip width. Roll up, shoulders down, reach up. Deep breath in. Exhale, release the arms and give yourselves a hand. Thanks for showing up.